If you guys are looking for coins to pull some packs or whatever else you need, right now my sponsor is doubling all coin orders for free, and you can use my code Saber for 10% off. Hey, what is going on, guys? Sabrtooth here, and today I'm going to be talking to you guys about some very important information regarding a new leaked promo that I found a bunch of information on, as well as opening a bunch of these packs to see if we could pull some Ultimate Legends or any of these new players that EA messed up and released a day early. Guys, if you are new to the channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button real quick. We're almost to 23,000 subscribers. I can't thank you guys enough. And hit that like button if you want me to continue coming out with leaks like this when I find some interesting information that a ton of people have questions about. I like making these videos, helps keep people informed, and I think you guys enjoy them. So first of all, what am I talking about? If you guys go to your auction block right now, under the program filter, you can see they've updated it. Now you can scroll down because there were too many promos for just the one page. And there's two new program filters, Ultimate Legends and Season Stars. Today I'm going to be talking about the Season Stars promo. Now this has been confusing a bunch of people I've seen online and in my league. And if you take a look, there's a bunch of gold and elite players that have suddenly popped onto the auction block and nobody knows where they came from or what they're used for. As you can see, there's a Series 1, Series 2, Series 3, a bunch of different series of these players. Now, the series, nobody really knows what this is about, but as you guys can see, these cards are selling for absurd prices. So if you guys pull any of these, right now is an amazing time to be pulling packs for both the Ultimate Legends and the Season Stars, which go for an absurd amount of coins because nobody knows what they are. So more or less, guys, as you can see, there's a bunch of different overalls, but they have no boosts. In my opinion, this is going to be a very similar promo to Final Edition, if you guys know what that was last year. More or less, it's a promo where they give a bunch of mediocre players who had decent seasons some pretty solid cards because they were lacking cards throughout the entire year. Some of these guys I've never even heard of, but hey, they decided to give them an upgrade, and I guess that's that. But if you guys look in your sets tabs right now, you will not see anything for the Season Stars promo. And people are wondering, did they release these too early? As you guys can see, these NFL playoff sets are expiring in just a few hours and will most likely be replaced by a Season Stars tab. Now, there should be a picture on the screen coming up right about now, and this will show you guys all the players that will be in the master sets for these Season Stars. Now, I'm going to go over each one of these stats because obviously you guys can't see the stats. So, first of all, we have a Davante Adams. To complete this set, you're going to need 4 of the Elite Season Stars, and then you're also going to need these Gold Season Star Banner collectibles, 6 of them. So in total, there's 10 items for every single one of these sets. The Davante Adams has 93 speed, 97 acceleration, 94 jumping, 95 agility, 91 catching. A pretty solid card, in all honesty, but I don't know. I don't really need a new wide receiver, so I probably won't get this one. The Quan Alexander is a very, very nice looking card. 90 speed, 91 acceleration, 91 awareness, 88 agility, 94 tackle, and 95 pursuit. I've loved Quan Alexander ever since he got this one card early on in the season. It was a really, really good budget beast. I believe it was around an 84 overall, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe it was an 82 overall. Pretty sure it was an 82 overall from early on in the season. Here it is right here. And he had great stats for that time, and his stats are just as good on this card. The next one that I want to be talking about is the Danielle Hunter. Now, this is a very well-rounded card. It actually has over 80 stats on every single one on the entire card. He's got 89 speed, 85 strength, 86 agility, 88 acceleration, 92 pursuit. Not going to read them all off, but really solid stats there. Melvin Gordon, this is one that's going to excite a lot of people. I may pick this guy up. 93 speed, 95 agility, 93 acceleration, 92 carrying, 94 elusiveness, 93 ball carrier vision, and 90 awareness. The last one's Ladarius Webb with 93 speed, 91 agility, 90 acceleration, 90 awareness, and a 91 zone and an 89 man. And Ben Jones, which is another one that's going to go for quite a decent bit of coins, with 92 strength, 94 pass block, 92 run block, 94 impact block, and 91 awareness. Now, that's a bunch of numbers right there. I'm sorry if that was kind of boring, but it just really, I just wanted to get that out to you guys and just kind of convey how good these players are. I think they're all going to sell for a pretty solid amount. I think Melvin Gordon, Ben Jones are probably going to go for the most if I had to guess. DNs aren't worth too much. Cornerbacks, there's a lot of good ones recently. So let's just rip through some of these packs. As you guys can see, I'm back up to 2 million and sold off a bunch of the stuff that I got in my pack opening yesterday, if you guys have not seen that. And just sold off a few of the players on my bench. Let's see if we can get any of these season stars. If you guys pull these, you guys need to be selling these as soon as you can. Even if they're gold ones, they're going to be going for 20,000 plus coins. At the end of this video, I'll show you guys a filter that I've been using to snipe off these season stars and make a pretty decent amount of coins by just sniping off golds. Now, the other one that I'm excited for has got to be the Quan Alexander. I don't think this card will go for as many coins as some of the other ones, such as the Ben Jones and Melvin Gordon, but just really good stats, and I don't think it'll make it on my team because I do have the 98 Derek Johnson as well as Brian Urlacher, but it's a pretty solid card overall. Now, I'm not sure exactly why these cards were released into the game already. I think somebody on EA's part just kind of messed up by putting them into packs. I'm not sure if you can do this, but if you guys don't know already, sometimes you're able to go ahead and set your phone or your device's clock forward a couple hours or a day or so, and then you'll be able to see new sets and new live events. It kind of glitches out the game now. It used to be a lot easier to do. That's how people would be getting all these leaks. I'm pretty sure that's how they got these set information online. I found these all online, obviously. But if you guys could do that, all right, two elites there, Zach Martin and Brandon Marshall. The only elites we've pulled so far of these packs right now, not looking too good. We're about 500,000 in. I'll probably pull about a million coins of these, see if we can get anything. The point of this episode really isn't the pack opening, because as you guys can see, I'm not getting much. It's more or less just giving you guys some information about this new promo as well as a sniping filter, because a lot of people I've seen are very, very confused on what is going on with the season stars. At first, I thought it was going to be something where you had to play season's games in order to get these, but that's not at all what they're about. It's more or less like Final Edition, and I kind of explained that a bit, but for you guys who didn't play last year, they give upgrades to players who didn't get upgraded cards for most of the year, and by the end, there's going to be a lot of high overall cards. None of them have boosts, unfortunately, but it looks like this may be a weekly set with new season stars released every single week, so that should be pretty exciting. Seven more packs here. So far, they've been really, really terrible. I've not had great luck with these Ultimate Legend packs this year. TJ Lang, not worth very much at all. I really wanted to pull a Boss Legend, but honestly, I just don't have enough coins right now. I have a bunch of coins invested in my team and on my bench. I have so many items on my bench. If you guys hadn't seen already, the Elite Trophy prices honestly kind of remain the same or even dipped like 1,000 coins a piece. And for you guys who invested a lot of coins, I'm truly, like, really sorry about that. I thought for sure that these prices would go up, but if you guys saw the set, there we go, Sterling Sharp. That's a cheap one, but at least it's an Ultimate Legend Elite pull. The reason that these trophies have not gone up in price yet is because the set that uses Elite Trophies and back-to-back Charles Haley, Tom Brady. All right, we'll take it a little bit better. Two more packs. At least we're starting to pull a few Ultimate Legends. Pretty bad ones, but I will take any Ultimate Legends that I can get, honestly. Can we get anything there? We get Max Strong. Our final pack, gonna get to just above a million coins. As I was saying, the reason that they haven't gone up is the set using Elite Trophies is really bad. We get Charles Haley to end it off. I will definitely take that. You can turn in Elite Trophies and you end up getting an Ultimate Legend badge, or you can pull that badge for pretty much free in a 50k pack. It's honestly a terrible set. I would never do it, but if you guys have a bunch of Elite Trophies, hold on to them, because sooner or later they're gonna drop another trophy monster. I can almost guarantee that. It'll probably need 100 Elite Trophies, and for you guys who've been sniping off these trophies, the trophy prices will raise up, or you can make that trophy monster right away and sell it off for a big profit. Now, for you guys who stayed this far into the episode, number one, thank you guys so much. Number two, I'm gonna show you guys what I've been doing with season stars. So if you guys look right here and look under 25,000 coins, you should see a decent amount of golds there. They're all dropping for around 25k at this point, but they're pretty expensive for just gold cards, and a lot of people don't really know what these are worth quite yet. So if you look under 40,000 coins, You guys have to be careful with these filters because their price is just going to keep falling as more people know what these cards are. But more or less what you guys can do is set the filter at 82 and up and look under something like 25,000 coins. That's what I've been doing. As you guys can see right here, both this Bethea and the Steven Nelson are pretty good snipes at 22,000 coins. The next cheapest Nelson looks to be about 35, so I'll undercut that a bit, probably make 10k on him. And the Bethea is another guy who's going for about 35k, so undercut, so probably about 20,000-25,000 coins there, which is not really that bad at all. In addition to that, these prices are going to be changing, so you guys got to be careful, but these cards drop pretty frequently. For you guys who have a bit more coins, what you can be doing is just go Season Stars Elite, set the price around 300,000 coins, and just take a look, see what's there. I've been seeing some of these cards drop for very cheap amounts, like that Marcus Cooper, as well as that Isaiah Crowell. I don't know if those are good snipes. The Cooper is not, but the Crowell might be. So let's go take a look, see what the next cheapest Isaiah Crowell is, because people have been getting just absolutely flooded right now with these season stars. And a lot of people don't know whether to buy them or not, and they're buying them for insane prices. You can really take advantage of that. That Crowell is not a great price, but I've been seeing some of these elites going for millions of coins for really foolish people who, I don't know, just didn't understand what this promo was about. That's why I wanted to make this video. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you guys all learned what Season Stars is. I'm kind of excited for it. These should be some pretty solid cards. Hopefully you guys can pull some of these season stars for yourselves. Go out there, get some good pack luck, guys. Break some ankles. Stay hungry, stay humble, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.